What's going on YouTube? I want to shout out all my alpha generals, generalettes, alpha males, and alpha females. Okay, so I don't want to make this video not too long. Like I told you, every 11th or 12th iteration video that I put into my lineup will be, you know, a speaking engagement, aka testimonial, or whatever you consider it. It'll just be me speaking. But I want to impute that if you stay to the end of the video, I will be showing you a few pieces that I'll be, you know, featuring in the future. Hopefully it gives you some incentive to still promote and follow your boy. Okay, so let's get to it. If you go to my Instagram, StevieDGSG, you know what I'm saying? StevieDGSG on Instagram. Every Monday I give a positive message with, you know what I'm saying, with how to start going about being confident. Now, I am not a doctor, I am not a psychiatrist. Everything that I am given is based off my experience. So whatever you can take from it, please take from it. If it doesn't relate to you, anything that I'm talking about, fine. You don't have to use it. You don't got to watch these videos. I won't be offended if you have different ideologies or agreements or disagreements. I just want to, you know, help those who probably can use my life story and my experience to their own life, or the things that I use as tools to gain my confidence and pick myself up, maybe they can use them, okay? So, on my first video on IG, not the first video, but the first Monday that I started giving these messages out, I said that the start to confidence, you know what I'm saying, is identifying with yourself. Now, it's easy for somebody to list 10, 20 things on how to be this and how to be that, but I know what some of you are thinking. How do I go about doing those things? How do I start those processes? So this is what I'll tell you. Like I said, once again, I am not a professional licensed psychiatrist or doctor. So that's my disclaimer. This is all personal experiences and life experiences. Okay. Now, with that being said and repeated, as you know, what I would do for you young men, young women, or older men, older women who struggle with, you know what I'm saying, confidence. You can't be too confident if you don't know who you are as a person, if you don't know what you identify with. Now, and I'm not even talking about sexual orientation just yet, because despite what your sexual orientation is, you know what I'm saying, even in those worlds, if you're straight, if you're gay, or whatever the case may be, you know, you still got to be confident in those spaces. So that's why I don't want to touch too much on sexual orientation just yet, because it don't matter who you love or who you decide to be around and date, you still got to be confident in those spaces if you want to, you know, be able to maneuver in those worlds. You understand? So what I would say is this. What helped me identify with myself is, who was around you? Think about who raised you. Was it your mother? Was it your grandmother? Some of us wasn't, you know, but didn't have our parents due to maybe them passing or due to some circumstance that they just wasn't able to be around. So was it an uncle? Was it a grandmother? Was it an aunt? Who influenced you the most? Who taught you the most? Whether bad or rather good, you know what I'm saying? Because what I might think is bad, you might think is good. So I'm not here to tell you about your life. I'm just here to give you those steps. So what I want everybody to do is list 10 good things about what you learned or who was around you, who influenced you, 10 good things or 10 good influences, and 10 bad things or 10 bad influences that these people that were before you, you know, showed you, taught you, or brought around you. You know what I'm saying? And before we could get to what outweighs what, just start listening. You know what I'm saying? Listening them. Because you got to go back in order to understand how to move forward. People say, oh, that's cliche, that's corny. But a lot of times, people don't understand. A lot of our depressions and sadness or things that we don't think well about ourselves start from somewhere. Whether it was you were 15, 12, 6, or even 3 years old. You understand? So list 10 positive things about yourself. 10 good things. 10 good things about what was around you growing up. You know what I'm saying? 10 good things, 10 bad things. And look at those things. And when you look at those things, identify what works for you Identify what you thought was right. You know, maybe you could switch them up. Identify with, this is what they taught me was right, and I later learned that this was wrong. So slide, which, you know, whatever it was, over to the wrong section. And this was what I was told was wrong. Now I realize that that could have been the right thing. Slide it over to the positive right section. You know what I'm saying? That's how you start to learn, or at least start to gain the identifying with self. That this is what I've been taught growing up, and this is what I can take from it that I feel like applies to my life. For instance, for me, I remember growing up outside the church and growing up inside the church, because I wasn't always in church, but I was more or less kind of raised in it, you know what I mean? So after, you know, there were a lot of influence around me. You know, I don't want to just blame my mom and my dad for the good and bad. I had a lot of influences around me. And for those good things, I thank my parents. And I now understand and appreciate why they taught me or told me and didn't let me do certain things. But for those other people, maybe some cousins, maybe some aunts or whatever, you know, some people, they have a way of telling you with their mouth the right thing to do. And then you see them, you know, in their life, and they're not doing the best thing possible for them and theirs. But, you know, it's not here for me to judge, but these are just my experiences. And, you know, when you start to identify with what was around you in your younger age, or what just influenced you the most, that can help you start to gain what kind of person you want to be. Because that's what I said, identify and think about the person you want to be. Because not everybody wants to be the same, right? Not everybody wants to be a fighter. Not everybody wants to be in the entertainment business. I used to want to be in the entertainment business, but I later learned that I'd rather be behind the scenes. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, all my brothers and sisters, we all sing and rap and do all these talented things. And in certain cases, I would rather be behind the scenes. I mean, I know it's kind of crazy, I'm on YouTube, but, you know, in certain cases, in certain facets, I would not rather be the one being seen. And it's not due to lack of confidence. It's just I like to maneuver in certain spaces without being, you know what I'm saying, noticed. So let's start with that. You know what I mean? Let's start with what we can identify with. And going back to me being raised in and out the church, excuse me, you know, I can identify with a lot of what's right within the church, or what I can pick up, what I gain that I think is very positive. Did I agree with everything within the church? No, I mean, I don't think essentially everything was wrong, but I think that maybe certain tactics and certain ways about handling things could have been handled different. You know what I mean? And, you know, my parents more or less were positive influences, or they attempted and tried to be to the best of their knowledge and best of their ability. So, you know, I'm not here to tell you what's wrong and right, because I don't live your life. And I can tell you this, I got tons of brothers and sisters, and most of them lived, you know, we grew up in the same household. And when you got 5, 10 brothers and sisters or whatever that you live with, y'all all see things different. And although we got the same parents with the same upbringings, you know what I'm saying? What I thought was probably right, my brother thought was wrong. What he thought was probably right, I thought was wrong. So, you know, it's up to the individual. So let's just start there. With our confidence, let's list these things out. Let's think about these things that influenced us in our lives, whether good or whether bad. And let's think about the people who were set before us. Now, I'm not saying judge them or go to them and attack them. I'm saying for yourself, if you want to identify or start identifying who you are, to start projecting who you want to be as a positive person, you got to go back. And that's just my opinion. If you don't like it, hey, I'm sorry. If you don't think it's good advice, hey, I'm sorry. You don't have to listen to me. I'm nobody. You feel me? But I am an alpha general. You feel me? Alpha male at best. You know what I'm saying? So I'll leave it there for now. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, that's what I had to do. I had to start thinking about what was around me in my younger years and what helped me become the man that I am, because I wasn't always as positive as I am now. Right now, I don't care attitude about certain things, about certain materials, about certain people's attitude towards me, about people who judge me because of my past decisions. You know what I mean? Because there's a lot of my past that makes me a good man. There's a lot of my past that I was able to work through and change to make me a more positive person. You know, I don't want to say that I'm a good person. That's for everybody else to judge, but I took a lot what was negative and tried to turn it into a positive, because essentially I do have a daughter, and due to my experiences with my fathers, because I do have a stepfather, you know what I'm saying? I took the good of the situations on both ends. And I didn't try not to dwell too much on the bad, or if I did take from the bad, I changed it with how I'm trying to raise my daughter. You dig? Okay, so now we're gonna leave it at that. For those who want to hit me up in my DMs, you know, my link in the description for my Snapchat, link in the description for my IG. Hit me up if you want to talk and discuss some things. These videos, you know, I hope they're helpful to people. I hope they can, you know what I'm saying, help you. But we'll start with that. 10 good things, 10 bad things, 10 influences, good influences, 10 bad influences. And start thinking about the people who are around you early on as a baby, as a kid. Whoever influenced you the most, bad or good, just think about what was around you and start listing things and swapping them, what was good, what was bad. And then we'll start there with how we go about being positive. You know what I'm saying? Or changing the narrative on what we think is what we think is negative about ourselves. You feel me? Because a lot of what we might think is negative about ourselves could very much be a positive. And you just don't know it yet because you're just so used to people pointing things out about you and being negative to you or treating you like you're the worst person in the world. And a lot of times when people treat you bad, it's because there's a lot of good in you and they're just jealous that they don't have it. And you might say, well, CBD, that don't make no sense. What do you mean? For instance, I'm a very talkative person. I'm a very friendly person. And I used to have had girlfriends or cousins or whatever. They used to, oh, Steven, you talk too much. Oh, that's why nobody likes you. Da, 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 da. And come to find out, it was because they're the ones sitting in the corner depressed. Nobody wants to be around them. Nobody cares to invite them out. I'm always being invited out and being encouraged to do other things. So, you know, let's try not to let other influences affect us too much at this point. And if they have already affected us, let's see which way we can reverse it. You feel me? So like I said, okay. Now, we're going to hit the portion of the video in which where I told y'all would show y'all some future pieces that I'm going to be reviewing. So for those who want to see that, stay on to this video. Okay, so we back. And for the first piece, for anybody who's interested, look what I got here. This one I have for probably one of my pieces I had for the longest, for over a year. This is a 19mm, 20-inch Cuban by GLD. It's one of my favorite pieces. I wore it all the time, and I constantly have to clean it because I was wearing it a lot in the summertime, and this thing is super duper heavy. So that's one piece. This one right here, I got a 19mm Cuban with CZ stones, gold, yellow gold by GLD. For those who care, look at those stones looking crazy. Okay, and as you already know, I probably showed you on another one of these videos, I got Franco chains. I got three of these, actually. I'm going to be giving one of them away. Franco chain. This is about, I think, 6 to 8mm and 20 inches long. And as I told y'all before, I have real gold. I showed y'all my small cross before. I told y'all I like crosses. I'm a big fan of crosses. Look at this. I'll probably be doing the review of the cross and the Cuban chain, you know what I'm saying, on two separate videos. I don't know. I haven't decided yet because I got a lot of info on these things. This is real gold, by the way. This is not GLD. You can't find it. I don't know. Maybe they'll have something in the future, but this is real gold. This is what I said I had from the, you know, 90s that I, you know, I don't wear it a lot. You feel me? But my uncle gave me this. And this is from the 90s. You can probably barely even find this anymore. And if you do find it, it won't be for the price point that, you know what I'm saying, he got it at the time. You feel me? And last but not least, I got more. I just can't show y'all all right now. Real gold bracelet. Feel me? Also from the early 90s on your boy. So hopefully y'all like what y'all just saw. Hopefully y'all stay tuned. Hopefully y'all like, comment, subscribe, and promote your boy as you should. Click my affiliate link if you want to buy anything from GLD. You know what I'm saying? If you like anything I presented, click my affiliate link and support your boy the way you should. And if these speaking engagements don't help, let me know. I'm going to be putting them in playlists. So for those who just want to see what I'm about, you know, as far as my personal life and these speaking engagements, I'm going to be, you know, organizing all these videos for you guys so y'all don't got to go through my whole catalog. And I'm going to timestamp this video for those who want to hear what I got to say about, you know, these speaking engagements, aka testimonials. And for those who just want to see the futuristic pieces, I will be previewing, okay? Or reviewing, rather. Sorry. So, you know what I'm saying? Until next time. I know y'all just got a little segment. Maybe the next video might be a little longer. This is just to see what y'all feel and if anything I say or, you know, either helps y'all or don't help you guys. Please, you know, don't be afraid to hit up your boy. Talk to me, because I talk back. But when you talk, talk to me nice. All right, guess what? I'm out.